everyone. I'm back once again with a very new chapter, but related to the first chapter. The first chapter was on equality, and this chapter is not the second chapter, but the very last chapter of your book, that is Struggles for Equality. What is Struggles for Equality? Now, you know that everything comes with a struggle or hard work. Suppose, I'm sure you people know this, for getting full marks in your exam, how much effort you people give, right? You practice, you read and you learn, and then you get good marks. Suppose you don't read the whole year or before exams you don't read or you don't practice, will you get good marks? I'm sure you will not get. For getting something, you will have to struggle for that. You will have to put a lot amount of effort, hard work, patience and everything to get that, to achieve this. The same way, equality, getting equality was not so easy task. People worked very hard, they struggled. It was not just putting hard work, but they actually struggled for equality. Now, as earlier we have discussed about the civil rights movements, what happened? A single woman stood up against the whole society, and obviously she was being supported by others, but she had that strength to stand. Same with Om Prakash Valmiki, coming from such a community, he raised himself, he protested against the society, though he was being supported by his parents. Here Rosa Parks was supported by many others like her. The same way, someone has to stand and others will have to support that person. Obviously, that person stands for a good reason, not for bad reason. Suppose someone stands for a very bad reason and we all go and support him. Yes, we want that. No, it is not like that. If a person is right, you think that person is right, what he or she is demanding is right, we should always support that person. So, today, as we all know, equality plays such a big role in our Indian constitution or in our daily life. Today, we will study about struggles for equality. Now, before starting with the topics of this chapter, I would request you people to please go again and again, over and over, word by word of this chapter, so that you may understand. Just reading it aloud or mugging up the question and answers won't help. You will have to understand. Okay, so let us start. Indian Constitution as a living document. Okay, so Indian Constitution as a living document. Why Indian Constitution as a living document? Because Indian Constitution has given much importance to the equality of a person, to the rights of the person. It has done a lot for keeping person's dignity alive, to make people feel comfortable in their own surrounding. Actually, Indian Constitution is doing a lot, but it is us who are not following that constitution. It is nowhere fault of our constitution. We are in fault that we are not following that properly. Right? Obviously, somewhere something is lacking, that is true enough, but we will also have to do our part, right? Our duties. I'm not blaming someone. Somewhere we are also in lacking. Somewhere a little bit our laws are also not so strong, I believe. That is totally my opinion. Now, but remember, your constitution or your government is doing a lot. People will have to change our mentality and we'll have to make people socially educated about our rights and everything. Now, what happened? A very famous fight against inequality was done by Tawa Matsya Sangha. Tawa, T-A-W-A, Tawa, M-A-T-S-Y-A. S-Y-A. Matsya means, you know, match. It's fish. So, Matsya Sangha. S-A-N-G-H. G-H. The Tawa Matsya Sangha is a group of fishermen. Now, what had happened when dams were built or forest areas declared sanctuaries for animals, thousands of people are displaced. Suppose a dam has to be built or a forest area will be declared a sanctuary so that no construction will be done in that area or no cutting of trees or no human will live there. A group of people, a lot, a huge number of people has to be displaced from one area to another. Now this is what happens when and most of these people are, you know, very poor. They're basti people. They don't have a fixed earning. They don't have a proper livelihood. Their life is surrounded in that area only, like a forest area. They do a little bit of cultivation, or if you think about fishermen, small fisheries they do, or like that. So when they have to displace from one place to another, it is very difficult for them to get settled in that area. Okay, because they do have family and they have to maintain their family. There's a lot going on. So what happened in Tawa Matsya Sangha, some of them are relocated to, some people are though by government relocated to new places, but the number is so huge that government also sometimes fails to do that. Right? The government appoints someone to do that, some problem arises due to this arrangement is not being done properly. Now this, what had happened, originating in Mahadua hills of Chindwara district, the Tawa flows through Betul before joining the Narmada in Hosanabad. The Tawa dam began to be built in 1958 and was completed in 1978. This is a huge time span, you will have to understand this. It submerged large areas of forest and agricultural land. The forest dwellers were left with nothing. Some of the displaced people settled around the reservoir, and apart from their meager farms, found a livelihood in fishing. They earned very little. Okay, so people were displaced and the dam has to be built. So people have to be displaced. The government arranged for their displacement. But somehow, for some reason, they were successful in rehabilitating a small group of people. A big number was left behind. Now in 1994, the government gave the rights for fishing in the Tawa Reservoir to private contractors. Now these contractors drove the local people away and got cheap labor from outside. The contractors, now what happened, those who were settled in near that area, they started beginning their new life by doing fishing from that Tawa river only. But what happened, and government for fishing gave contractor means someone who is given assignment. Suppose assignment was given by government to a contractor, or the person who gets that assignment is a contractor. We call him contractor. Now the contractor, what did he did? He appointed people from outside instead of taking people from those villages so that they could get livelihood or earn money out of it. He asked people from outside villages to come and help him doing that work, so that he will have to pay less amount to those people. Now what happened? The newly formed Tawa Matsya Sangha organized rallies and chakka jam. Now people were very much agitated and they were very much angry because they thought that they will at least earn something out of this. But when they realized that contractor, instead of giving them job, is appointing people from outside, and they were not given to do fishing also, their livelihood was blocked. Then a group was formed called Tawa Matsya Sangha. That area was Tawa. Matsya means fish, Sangha means committee. So Tawa Matsya Sangha. What did they do? They started protesting against. They did chakka jam, you know, roadblock, that we will not allow anyone to travel from here and there, demanding their rights to continue fishing for their livelihood. so that they can do their they can do fishing and they can earn livelihood. And I believe in it's all my opinion that they were right in a way, because they were being uprooted from their place, shifted somewhere else, and they were not given proper rehabilitation. And after all those things, when they started their new life, thinking that they will earn a bit from fishing, in contractor or illegally appointed people from outside, and they were given no rights, they had nothing to do, and so they formed this and they protested against this. In response of their protest, the government created a committee to assess the issues. Now, government can't take decisions so quickly in a fraction of a second. They did what? Government, after hearing them, government appointed few people to look into this matter. And when this matter was looked by those government appointed people, the committee recommended that fishing rights should be granted to the villagers for their livelihood. In 1996, the Madhya Pradesh government decided to give to people displaced by the Tawa Dam the fishing rights for the reservoir. A 5-year lease agreement was signed 2 months later on January 2nd, 1997. So, what happened? I must tell you people, please go through this Tawa Matsya Sangha, what had happened, because when I am saying, I am just giving you a gist what had happened. You should know exactly everything, the dates and everything you should remember. So in gist what happened, the people who were displaced because of this new formed reservoirs and everything, they fought for their right and they gained their right. And then what happened, government said what they were demanding was actually needed. So they granted them their rights and said that they can do fishing for their livelihood. Now, like this, this is just one example of a struggle that people had for their livelihood. There are several others. There are many others. Like, there's a huge struggle that people has done. This is just a bit. Now, you know that what people have struggled, how much for our independence. You all know the efforts our freedom fighters have given for our independence. So, suppose in the same way, people have given a lot. They have struggled a lot for our equality. It's not just my equality or your equality. It's a whole society's, whole country's equality. Now, there's a beautiful adaptation of a song written as a part of the Rights to Information campaign by Vinay Mahajan. There's a beautiful song. I must recommend you people to read it. If you read it by heart, you will feel that pain and that struggles people have gone through so that we can enjoy our equality. So whenever you think that equality, don't ever misuse your equality. Like, all these things that people have actually done a lot so that we can enjoy our equality. And this is what I have to tell in this chapter, Struggles for Equality. I would request you people to please go through this chapter word by word, and if possible, if you can, please search what are other movements or other obviously movements that were organized to gain equality. I will definitely give you other movements that have actually happened for our equality, but I want you people to also search for that. Thank you.